Hi everyone, I'm back again. Technical problems. I hope you are seeing my video now in a landscape version so you can see what's going on. So I'm just refreshing my screen to get that going. Refreshing my screen on my laptop. If someone can just please comment to see that they have a landscape, if they now have a landscape view, that would be awesome. This is quite bizarre. Don't you love technology? Right. Okay, I'm just checking. Very strange. So, hi Jennifer, you're watching. Thank you. Can you tell me, please? Can you see the screen in like? Can you see the whole thing in across your screen like this, or is it if you're just seeing it up and down? Okay, truly sorry. I'm going to have to turn it around, I think, which is not part of the plan. Oh, technology is great when it works. Sorry about this, guys. I have to get my okay. Yeah, is that better? That shouldn't be, it shouldn't be like this. It's not going to be the best, but what do you do? Can't understand what Facebook is doing to me. Did this exactly the same the other day without a problem. So, oh dear. All right. Oh my goodness. Okay, we're just going to have to go with this. So, I'm sorry, guys. Oh, you've probably got a headache now. Okay. Thank you for coming in. I should say, g'day. G'day. This was all neat. All right. So we'll get started. Thank you for tuning in. Bit of a rough start. I'm very sorry. Thanks, Alison, for letting me know what's going on there. Hi, Noreen. And anyone else I've missed, let's get started. So your Spectrum Noir tri-blend markers are, I'm just going to turn my laptop volume off, are a wonderful product, fairly new to our range. These have the three colours on them, obviously, a light, a mid colour and a dark colour. So I want to just quickly show you a couple of examples on scrapbooking pages that I've coloured. I just want to make sure that, yes, that's in the view. And what I'm going to put down, just this, I find this is really helpful. This gives me a centre shot, so I should have had that down. So I might just put that down. did that just make sure I'm actually in the center. Sorry about this. I might just move. I'll leave those there for a minute and I'll explain what they are. Right, back to this. So, just to show you very quickly, because I know Layla has shown some alcohol pens colouring on her, I believe, in her card video, making her Stamp of the Month card kit up. But that's a page I did when we had this, this stamp set and thin cut set. So this is a page and product bundle that we had a couple of months ago. And I'm going to start on these pages just to explain a couple of the things I've done. Hi, Yvonne. I can see your name's popped up. Welcome. Okay, that's everybody, I think. Without going into too much detail, I just want to show you some ideas of what you can do to up the ante on your layouts. So these flowers here weren't bright enough for me. So I have followed the lines that were on the original leaves and flowers, and I've come in with some coordinating colour to just elevate this artwork a little bit more. Okay, you can also see on here we have a wooden little padlock, and for this we use the technique of colouring in with the tri-blend markers, which really made a difference. You can also see here I've added extra color to the bird. Okay, so don't be afraid to do this, basically to elevate your artwork by adding a little pop of color to any embellishments. So these were the die cuts out of the kit that were probably that, well, they are our B&T duo thickness, I think, or maybe a little bit thicker. Not as thick as cardstock. I can't remember. Yeah. So I'm yet to put some heritage photos on here. I haven't quite got the right ones I haven't got enough to actually finish the layouts. I want to think about what I'm doing before I do it. So that gives you an idea there. I've just brought in a little bit of artwork just to show you some of the things I've done with the tri-blend markers. These are pretty basic on cardstock. These were using the other range we had. So that one is. These other ones I'll show you. These are all using the Spectrum Noir. So the tri-blend. And do you remember the Love Wagon? So I have actually made it into a cow. So this was the Combi Van, just to show you. And I hand drew the cow on there. And you can see the shading I've done on there. And this was a straight copy out of the last 2 monthly idea book, and creating the shading on the boots and a little bit of shading up there on the flowers. Okay, so I've just got my color wheel. You can download this color wheel from the Make It From Your Heart, Close to My Heart blog. There probably will be an updated one when we get a new catalog, because we always know that some colors will go and some new colors will come, which is rather exciting. I laminated this one. This was just a basic one that just shows you your different segments without bringing in all of it. So it just made it a little bit easier. And I'll come back to this, because I want to show you something just to help you with your colour selection. So that's what this is out for. So I will come back to that. So I will move that aside and get started on actually doing something practical. So the first thing I'm going to show you is, and this is something that some of you have probably used and done, is this is vellum. I'm going to zoom in so you can see a lot better what I'm going to do using the tri-blend markers. I might not zoom in that far because then I'm going to be out of view. So I'm going to pick a nice green. What will I go for? I might go for this one. This is the light green blend. Okay. All right. So we've got a few people that have joined us. Hi, everybody. Barbara, and I said hello to everyone. Michelle's back. Thanks, Michelle. Thanks for popping back in after my dramas. Okay. So what I like to do with the vellum, firstly, I always use our intense black and give that a moment to dry because I know that my artwork won't smudge when I start colouring in. But when I'm doing, when I'm working on vellum, I still stamp that, but then what I do is I like to work from the back. So I'll show you what that looks like. So I'm going to start with just a little, couple of little flicks of the lightest green. So I'm working on the light end of the marker, just really quickly. Okay. Right. So you can just see a little bit. You can definitely colour in from the front, but if you want that subtle look, this is a really great way to go. So I'm just going to add a little bit of the mid-coloured green now, just a smaller flick. You don't have to be precise with this either, so you don't have to spend lots of time blending. So I'm just putting a little bit more. And of course, being alcohol, that dries quickly. All right, so you're building up a little bit of color. And then with the dark, just probably smaller flicks than I was doing. So just keeping that just at the base of the leaf. So sometimes you just want things to just add a little bit of texture, like a little vellum die cut leaf, add a little bit of texture to your and a bit of interest to your card or scrapbooking layouts or designs you're doing. So you just want a little bit of color. Okay, so I hope you can see there. I have to keep standing up and sitting down. Okay, I like to do it from the back. And also it's a little bit more forgiving because, one, it's a small area, and two, because you're doing it from the back, you won't see if you go outside the lines as much as well. Okay, so that is curling up from the alcohol on it, I'd say. Or it might be, I had this one pre-cut put back in the stamp set, so... Actually, no, it wasn't in the stamps. It was in a little bowl. I keep little bits and pieces in a bowl beside me. So that is that's number two on my list. What I wanted to say is I have 20 actual tips for you. So you might need to take a toilet break in between and come back and catch up and then rewatch later because we have quite a few things to go through. Right, so we're going to do we're up to number three. This is going to be a fun one. Okay. Oh, I didn't show you this one. Funny about this, I made this a good few years ago, and it's still in my cards. But funnily enough, in the last 6 months, we've actually bought a puppy that looks like this. So it's rather funny. All right, I just thought I'd show you that. But that's one I made. Okay, so the next one is using texture paste. I'm going to show you what you can do with texture paste. So, that rolled straight out. Okay, so we have three mini jars of this one, and we do have a large jar of one of them, which is the, got it right here, okay, opaque mat. This is probably my favorite one to work with, although I haven't done a lot of work with it. I've been using the smaller jar, to be honest, but yeah, I don't know, I like this one. I'll show you how to use this. With this, I'm going to be using my palette knives. So I'll get those out. I am going to be needing some baby wipes for cleaning up. You don't need to use these. You could use, I'll show you what to do anyway, but you could use some baby wipes. I'm going to use my all-purpose mat, which is great for mixed media, any sort of mixed media that you might be doing. So I'll bring that in. And so we're going to start off with, I'm going to do one example for this one. I'll just find, where are we? Bear with me, I'll just find the right sample. So for this also, I have some stencils, which I have used our stencil film. Okay. So you can actually use your any like background dyes or anything at all. Or I have used the Cricut to cut out. We've got lots of overlays and different things you can resize on the Cricut to make your own stencils then with the stenciling material. So I've got a few here that I have cut. So we're going to have a little bit of a play with these. So I'm going to select the transparent matte. So transparent gloss, I'm not going to do that one. Transparent matte. Okay, I could do opaque matte, but actually I'm going to use a couple of different ones, sorry. So yeah, so this one here, I'm going to start with the transparent matte. I need to have a bit of a card base. Now you can use my little washi tape may have actually disappeared on me. Where have we put that? Washi tape or purple tape, whatever, you know, or any sort of low tack tape. I know it was here not long ago. Here it is. Okay, so it's really good to I'm going to hold this down. Some of these little pieces of white cardstock I have cut a bit larger than what I need. I'm not sure if this one, I've made them so that they obviously are matted with a couple of layers, this is your top layer, and then when you make your card you have a couple of layers underneath it of colored cardstock. For the first one, now I've chosen some colors already. I'm actually going to go with this brick pattern. Okay, I'm just going to hold that there, and I might just put a little bit at the bottom. Okay, bear with me 1 second. I'll see if I can actually do this. Give me 1 second while I just sort this out. No, that's not going to work. Okay, still can't seem to share that. Okay, back to here. All right, not to worry. So here we are now. So with the textured paste. First, I'm going to select my color. I'm going to select the orange. I'm going to go with the dark. I'm going to scribble some on my mat here. Look at that beautiful rich color. I'm going to choose one of my knives. Now, this texture paste, oh, that must have stuck back down. Or maybe I, no, it did. It stuck back down. So this does dry very quickly. I would suggest you keep your, I can see, I'm just going to zoom back out a bit. So I've scribbled some onto the side there, the orange. Yes, make sure you keep your liner for your lids. Don't throw them out. And this does dry out really quickly. So I'm just going to mix this with the ink I've put down to give myself an orange. I'm going to add some more. Try not to get the texture paste on the end of your marker. It will come good, but I did accidentally do it. So don't do what I did. Just do as I say. Because, it probably wouldn't take too nicely to a whole heap of that. So I'm just going to quickly pop that on. And you do need to work fairly quickly because it will dry. I will get as much up as I can, and hopefully, I didn't mix up too much. So I will then pop this aside and turn that into a card at a later time. And I might, if I can get something done over the weekend, I can put it in the artwork folder. Okay. So you don't want it on too thick either. But there's our first one. Now, quickly, I'm going to take this off so that we don't get it tearing at the cardstock. I have a bowl of water here beside me. Actually, it's a container with a lid on it, so I didn't slop it everywhere. I'm going to just put that straight in, and I'm going to sink it to the bottom. Grab myself a wipe, clean off my tools, clean off my desk mat, my all-purpose mat. There we go. Not too messy. Okay, this needs to go aside to dry. I'm just going to peel that off. Okay, that's our first background. What do you think? That looks pretty cool. So you do, as I said, you do have to work fairly quickly. I can see I have a little tear where it started drying and it's torn a little bit of the cardstock. It's not meant to be perfect. It's meant to look a bit grungy, I think. So I don't think that's going to be a problem. So I'll do something creative to cover that little tear. But there you go. There's our first one. I'll put that aside. I've got a couple of pegs hanging around, but they're actually attached to the... they're attached to the arm of the video camera, which is not a good place really right now. I'll get those off because I like to peg them up and they're out of the way because I don't want to put my arm in them, which is what we tend to do quite often. All right, so next one, I'm going to give you a couple of ideas. So this time we're going to choose, right, that was the orange. So I'll put that one back. And we're going to try the transparent gloss this time. So that's that one. Right, this one. And I'm going to choose a dark purple. Dark purple blend. Scribble this onto the mat. It works better on the mat if it's dry. So I think it was probably a bit damp, but that's fine. That gives us an idea. So that's the purple blend. I've used the dark end. So you can see probably why it's a good idea to keep these little liners, because when you put the lid on your texture paste, it would glue the lid down, basically. So, yeah, if you haven't got that liner in, you are going to possibly have a little bit of trouble getting getting the lid off. All right, I'm going to go with will I go with this one? I'm going to use that for something else, I think. Sorry. Indecisive. Too many options, ladies. Right. So, yeah, I'm going to be really bold. I'm going to actually do it twice. We'll see how this goes. Okay. I haven't really got that straight, so we'll just straighten that up. Okay, I can see that that's going to be in the way. So what I might do is make it into a circle, that bit of washi tape. And that way my washi tape, make it into a circle, put it on itself, and then stick that down that way. All right, so we're good to go. So I've actually got this palette knife, which I found quite good. So I'll show you how this one works. Once you get the... that's been sitting on there a while, but once you get the texture paste on, it starts moving. I can see that hasn't changed it very much, so I'll just add a little bit more. I have a feeling this was a pen that I used for something else that was not such a good idea, perhaps. Maybe it's dried it out. So with these marker pens, it is, they're a more expensive item when you look at it as a single item than if you're wanting to buy the whole set. But by the end of this, I hope you'll be able to see the value in them. Now, because I didn't mix this texture paste with the colour straight away, I can see I've got some colour that's a bit lumpy. But I don't think that's going to be a problem. So with this palette knife, you can actually go along and clean up the edge. I'm just going to clean off my pieces. I'm going to just pop my lid on too, just so that's not getting the air to it. Just going to give a quick clean up around, and then I'm going to lift it straight up, move it down to the next section, and probably I don't have enough, but we will make do for the sake of this exercise. Okay. Add a little bit more in there, and we'll just call it done. Okay. I could have mixed up some more. So once again, I'm going to put this straight into my water bath, off to the side, wipe down my palette. I did leave a bit on there, didn't I? I think the baby wipes are really good for the cleanup. I'm just going to lift up the corner of this and go for another baby wipe just to make sure I've got it all off and give it a chance to dry before I work with the next one. Okay, and just going to wipe around the edge. I didn't do that with the other one because we didn't go straight to the edge or right to the edge, did we? That's okay, that's fine. So again, a bit messy, but and I can see I've got a gap across the middle, but it's just to give you a general idea. I could have made the stencil a whole lot bigger, but, I could always go back when this dries, I suppose, and try and redo it, but it may not match up the colour. I haven't got much room for pegs on this one, so I've got a little drying rack here. I might just sit it in there. Hopefully that'll work. All right. Okay, I might just dry that off. Help that dry out. Okay, we're on. Yep, we're still focused here on camera. Good. Just dry off my spatula. Okay, so that's using the transparent gloss with the purple blend marker. Okay, so the next one will be the, I'm going to use the turquoise blue blend. I'm going to use the dark. I'm going to grab another piece of cardstock. And this time, what am I going to do this time? I might go, why not? I might go with a blue heart. So, actually, I might use these because this is a bigger stencil. I'll move it up a bit so we'll make sure we're in the middle. I can't see where I am on the middle of my Versamap, but I think I'm pretty central. There you go. So this one, I'll just tape that down over here. So it doesn't quite fill the whole card, so we'll just try and center it and go from there. All right, so we've got the blue turquoise blend, and I'm using the dark end. Now, I decided to do these texture pastes as one of the first demonstrations that I'm doing, simply because they take a while to dry. There's some techniques that we want to do that I want to do that require things to be dry. So, but I just thought I'll get in and do these first. Hope that makes sense. It doesn't really, does it? Anyway, just mixing that together. It obviously, because the texture paste is white, you get a lot softer look. So if you're looking for a darker colour, I'm just going to go with this lovely soft blue. I think it looks gorgeous. And you don't need a thick layer, okay? So the thinner the layer, obviously the quicker it will dry as well. I actually quite like this angled spatula. I actually find it quite good. I can get around the cardstock quite quickly. I think these little jars are really good to actually have a... Oh, I did an ombre effect with this. That's what I did. So what I'm going to do is, with another spatula, just grab out some... Not too much, because I've really got quite a bit there. I'm just going to pop the lid on. So you can certainly do the ombre effect. And I started then from the bottom and came up. And, you know, it's just a bit of play. It's whatever. Okay, I don't want to get too much on there, and I have. It's going to be a little bit lumpy bumpy. So anyway, I've just smoothed it off fairly well, I think. I'm just going to wipe off. Actually, I'll do the stencil first because it's been on there a while. Okay, of course my phone rings in the middle of it, doesn't it? Okay. Stencil straight into the bucket of water. Clean off my spatula next. Make sure that that's off there. Okay, just a touch of ombre. Okay, it's really important to clean up that mat as soon as you can. Okay, and just dry that off. So now we've done three different backgrounds using three different texture pastes. So I'm going to pop this third one aside. Just going to clean up that bit of texture paste there. Sometimes a baby wipe is good as well, just to get that off. But at the end of the day, you know, you can always cut down a panel. But that gives you an idea. Looks quite lovely. I like that colour. Blue's one of my all-time favourites. Okay, so I'm going to pop that up here on a peg. Or maybe not. Maybe I don't have enough room. Oh, there we go. That's got it. Okay. All right. So I hope you've liked that so far. Yeah, Michelle, you've got to go and do something. That's quite okay. All of these will be saved in our group. So just put, when you're looking for it, you can just put in the Spectrum Noir or just the title of the video. So even just any search word, so Spectrum Noir should bring that up. Okay, so next on the list, hi Dulcie, hi Andrea, hi Lisa and Audrey. Thanks for joining. Yep, Susan's there. Awesome. Adorable, you like that? Good. All right. Hi, Lauren. I'm sorry if I've missed anybody. So there we go. So that's those three. Texture paste. Now, I'm up to the next one. Oh, yes. Okay, so the next one. Okay, so what I might not actually do this from start to finish, but it's basically just using this stencil and then letting it dry and then colouring it. And I didn't leave it long enough for it to dry. So I've got a little bit of unevenness and so forth. I just got a little bit impatient. So that's another thing you could do with your alcohol pens, alcohol markers. Okay, so I'm going to keep going. So that's that one. Here are some I have done. And you can see here I left the stencil on too long. And it's torn into the white cardstock. A little sample I did, okay, with the gloss, transparent gloss. Again, with that purple. The purple's the only one I've done so far where the actual purple has left little spots in the texture paste. I don't know if it's the pen or the fact that I just left it on the mat a little bit too long. Here was my ombre one that I did my test piece. That worked out really nicely. I really quite like that. Again, it's blue. Of course I like it. All right. That's all those samples. So what we're going to do next is an embossing folder technique. Alcohol markers. An embossing folder. Okay, who would have thought? So let me get that organized for you. I'm going to show you how that one works. Just going to take my all-purpose mat away for now. Back onto my Versamat, which gives us a nice firm surface. So I have a couple of embossing folders. We have this one that's still in our on our websites for you to purchase. This is the Constellation one, and I haven't got the full name for it, but you will find it under embossing. But yeah, I don't know where I put the packet. The other one that I'm going to show you is this gorgeous one. Okay. And yep, so that's Constellations. And this one is also available and it's Flower Garden. Not sure if they're sort of in wild stock, like in the online only section with, or, you know, going soon, or yeah, sorry, I think I've got the words wrong, but there could be discounts on them. I'm not entirely sure. Maybe that one, but that one would be regular price. So that's a handy little one. That is some stars you can use anywhere. Okay, so right. So we'll get on with this. So I've got a piece of, now this technique you could do with, I'm going to do it with watercolor paper for this one. and show you how this works. So what you want to have a look at is you want to look at your embossing folder. Just run over it with your hands and have a look for the raised up side. I'm going to do this one in black. And somewhere I have a black. Here we are, back here. All right, so I'm going to use my, this one has a chisel end. We only have two markers that I think that have the chisel end. I haven't got the clear one here at the moment, but I think it has a chisel end and the black has a chisel end. They are the two markers that we have, the black and the blender one, that are a different size and they're actually a different shape. Okay, so I hope you can see that. So they don't have the three sections, obviously, for obvious reasons. So I'm going to, on the up risen side, I'm going to quickly go over these, trying not to touch the areas around it. So the chisel end is really good for this. Don't worry if it dries fast, because I'm going to show you what to do. They clean up quite well, and they're not going to anything left on here is not going to damage your dry embossing when you go to use your folder. If you go nice and slowly rather than me rushing, okay, you won't get little bits off the side. But I'm trying to cover a bit of ground in a limited time frame, so a little bit rush. I am rushing a little. Okay, so you've got that on there. Before I actually do the next step, I'm going to bring in my embossing machine very quickly. Oh, there's a card that snuck under there. Some blending on that one. Now I have a Big Shot, which I've had, and I've also got a Cuttle Bug, so I haven't switched over to the Close to My Heart machine, which we have as a hostess reward, which is lovely and compact, nowhere near as heavy as this, and it's got lots of features to it actually. And it's really, really great, but I just don't sort of see the need at this stage. Now, I have some isocol rubbing alcohol. I've got a large bottle, but I've got this spray top bottle. So you could buy a larger bottle and then put it into a squirty bottle. You might have a small squirty bottle at home somewhere. You can use it like a spray. We used to have these in our range, but for water, you can also put colour in these to make your own spritzer. But, we used to carry those, but they're not in our range quite at the moment. For this technique, we're looking at the alcohol. Because our ink has dried on here, I need to use the alcohol to start moving that. So I'm going to just spray this. You may not see me do it. Just be quite generous. You want it to be wet enough to move the alcohol. So it's pretty drippy. So I'm going to put that onto here, straight down, press it in. I hope you can see, right, and shut the door. Then pop it through your embossing machine like you normally would your embossing folder. What I love about this technique is that, it leaves a great impression. Now, I did do it on the wrong side. I've written watercolor on there, so I knew which one I was picking up. So, can you see that lovely impression? I thought that was cool. This is something I discovered myself. I thought, let's try this. So that will dry. Now, when it dries, because these are indented, you could do an ink pad swipe across here with a blue. That would be really good. So the ink would just sit on the high parts, and because these are sunken in, it won't go onto those. You could also use your finger daubers or sponges with inks and go on over that. So I just thought that was really cool. Just such a cool idea. And when the alcohol dries, you'll probably get, I can see some little bits of smudges of the colour because I did put quite a lot of alcohol on there. But you could certainly, just experiment and give it a go is what I would say and see what you think. But if, I mean, for this one, I'm thinking I'll definitely run a piece of, run an ink pad over it or my daubers or something to maybe hide some of those smudges. But there you go. So I'm going to sit that aside, go on to the next one. So you can see I've got a little bit of ink left on there, but that's fine. I can clean that up later. Put that aside and worry about that later. Okay, so we've got this one here. I'll show you this. You can probably see already what I'm going to do with this one because you probably saw that I have some ink left on here. I think this is going to take a while to do, so I'm sort of not so, this could just blow out to quite a long amount of time. So what I might do is, I haven't tried it with watercolour paper, and I've got this little strip. What size is this? So that's about 4 inches. So I'll just do a small area here. I'll show you a finished piece in a moment that I've done when I tested. So I'm going to, for this one, let me see, did I choose a colour? I'll just go with, I was going to choose a different colour, wasn't I? I was going to do a bright pink. All right, so for this one, I'm just going to colour where I'm going to put down my piece. I'm going to choose a section that has a couple of flowers in it. Just quickly colour the flowers in. Oops, sorry, I've done the wrong thing. This is the indented side. Oops. All right, that's probably not going to come off. Oh, that's sort of coming off with my chamois. Yes, you need the uprisen side. Duh. Okay. All right. Bright pink. Going to get my head in here. Just quickly colour a couple of flowers. You've got some little blossoms and some leaves. So we'll just quickly give you an idea of how this will work. I don't think we're going to get this one in, but I'll colour it just in case I happen to move it over. All right, so there's 4 flowers. Using the dark end of that one. I might go with the jade green. And I'm getting a collection here on my desk, so I might just put a couple of those back. And I might use, I'm just going to live on the edge and go with some blue. Okay, and one there. All right, so I'll do the leaves. This might be a bit dark. I didn't, that might work. Okay, we'll just quickly colour these leaves. And don't forget to do the stems. I love how this actually comes out when we do it and when it dries. It's really, really nice. So I'll just colour in some of these little pieces off to the side because chances are they are going to be in the spot. They're going to be on my panel, so all right. Not being too fussy. All right, and one more colour. I've got my green, got my, yep, okay. Have I got some a nice bright yellow? Here we go, what's this one? No, that's an older one. That is an older one. Maybe this is the older ones that we don't keep anymore. I'll just I might just do a little bit of yellow over those, just because I had it out. Okay. I think I've pretty well covered the flowers and the leaves that are going to be in that section. Right, I think we've been going not quite an hour, so what I'm going to do is finish off this technique. I'm going to start another live to do part two, simply because it doesn't let us or doesn't let me save and share my videos, so I had trouble with that yesterday. So bringing in my Big Shot. Bang. It is heavy. The Big Shot is heavy. I'm going to open out all the tabs. I could use one tab down, but this worked. Sometimes, especially with this paper, it's a bit thicker. Now, I've got to admit, I haven't actually done this technique on watercolor paper, so I'm interested to try. This is our watercolor, the Close to My Heart watercolor paper that they stock in the actual tear-off pad, which is this one that we have now. So, I definitely need to give this a go. So, before I do that, I need to spritz. Give it a nice spritz. Put the lid on. While it's wet, I'm going to put that in. Press it down. Okay. You can also wet your cardstock first if you want. Is another option. I did try that. And sometimes that actually works better. And I'll explain why in a minute. It's something, yeah, you definitely need to. It depends on your whatever product you're using, but yeah. So here we go. I'm going to lift that straight off. Okay, so at the moment it's quite wet, but that just gives you another idea. Now, if you turn it over, if I had wet the cardstock first, I would have more of that color coming through to the back. So here's one I did as my sample piece, and it's dry. And that's the back. I have another technique I'm going to show you that actually works quite well by spritzing the paper first. So we'll get onto that in the second half of this tutorial. So thank you for watching part one. Just give me a moment to set up part two and we'll get on with that. Thank you.